Sweet, man. So how long have you been doing this for?
I've been doing it for about 3 years.
Oh, okay. Cool, cool, cool. Yeah, I love that we can, you know, finally do this in person. It's so great to experience this live, even though, you know, it's behind a screen.
Yeah, we're actually live streaming it out right now.
Oh, no kidding. You guys are streaming this out right now?
Yep.
On the artist's website?
Yep.
Oh, cool. Oh, I definitely have to check this out.
Yeah, you should check it out for sure.
What?
Pretty cool, right?
This is so cool.
Yeah.
There's almost no delay between what I'm seeing on screen and what's actually happening in there. That's super impressive. And the quality is like 4K.
Yeah, quality's high. Quality's high.
You know, when I do my streams, the best I can get is like, you know, 1080p and, you know, like 15 seconds of delay. So it's nuts that you're able to get it with that much, with that little latency.
Yeah, like 4K.
Oh, you guys are using Dolby.io streaming?
Yeah,
from Dolby from this camera right here?
Yeah, this one. This one right here. Yeah.
So how does the live stream viewer actually work? Well, Dolby.io streaming supports a number of different SDKs, including a JavaScript SDK, which we'll be using in this video to demonstrate building the live stream viewer. Now, you can import this SDK in a couple of different ways. You can use NPM to import it, or you can import it through the JS Deliver Content Delivery Network, or CDN. In this example, we're going to use the CDN option, which you can import using this statement here. Now, you want to make sure you include this in the head of your file, as we're going to need to import the SDK before any of the scripts begin running. Great. So in addition to importing the SDK, which allows us to, you know, build our live stream viewer and leverage a ton of amazing tools, we also need to add a video element into the body of our HTML file, which you can add with this one right here. Now, it's important to include this into the file, as this is what the live stream is actually going to be streaming into and what your viewers are going to end up seeing. Now, finally, we're going to want to include a brain for this live stream video, something that handles all of the button clicks and adds nice UI changes as people, you know, join a stream and leave a stream and all that sort of stuff. And we can add that using the script tag in the bottom of our HTML file. Now, I'm actually going to have someone throw me this one off screen. So right here, I'm wide open. There we go, right there. Now, this is what you want to include in the bottom of your HTML file. And this script is going to contain the brain of all of our stuff. With the SDK imported, our video player placed, and our HTML and JavaScript files linked, we can change over to our JavaScript file to learn about how we authenticate and connect to a live stream. There are three main steps for authenticating and connecting to a Dolby.io broadcast inside of our JavaScript file. Step one, the token generator. The first step in connecting to a stream is to define our token generator. Since we imported the SDK via a CDN, we need to preface all SDK functions with window.millicast, then the function, in this case, director.getSubscriber. Additionally, for the token generator, we also have to include the stream name and the account ID. In our example, we utilize user input to get these values. However, there are a variety of different options for generating these tokens. Using our token generator, we can create a millicast view option, which we will use to connect to the broadcast. Step 2, adding the stream to our video tag. Next, we need to add the stream to our video tag, defined in the HTML. To do this, we define a function called addStreamToYourVideoTag, and listen for a track event, such as a broadcast updating, to add to our video tag. As for our function addStreamToYourVideoTag, it just takes in the stream element and sets our video tag's SRC object equal to it. Step 3, connecting to the stream. The final step in building our live stream viewer is to specify a few stream settings and connect to the broadcast. First, we define an options object, which contains three main parameters: disable video,
which is set to false because we want the video enabled. Disabled audio, which is also set to false because we want the audio enabled. And bandwidth, which is used to set data transfer limits. However, we set it to zero in this case, which means unlimited bandwidth, since we are only testing the app. Next, we can call the connect function using our millicast view object and our options object. We surround this function with a try-catch statement in case bandwidth issues prevent the broadcast from connecting immediately. With the connect step complete, we are now able to join a millicast broadcast. We can see all these steps put together here on screen. And the result is a live stream viewing platform powered by WebRTC.